For Republican advocates, being in charge means not only taking back control, but holding the British accountable.
Hi, guys.
You know, it's not that we're asking for a handout. We're saying you have reaped the benefits for 500 years or more, right? We're saying you have stolen and benefited, and now we want back what we have earned. We want back what we have earned to benefit our people.
Opal Palmer Edissa is a poet and a leading voice in the Republican movement. She took a stand against a recent royal visit. With Buckingham Palace some 7,000 kilometres away, royal visits have been a way for the monarchy to maintain their connection. Royals William and Kate marked the Queen's Platinum Jubilee with a visit to Jamaica in 2022.
No!
But for many, it just reminded them of a dark history. Opal banded together with other Republicans like Professor Rosalie Hamilton. They wrote a letter to Prince William demanding an apology from the royals for centuries of slavery.
One part of the letter said, "We see no reason to celebrate 70 years of the ascension of your grandmother to the British throne because her leadership and that of her predecessors have perpetuated the greatest human rights tragedy in the history of humankind. During her reign on the throne, your grandmother has done nothing to redress and atone for the suffering of our ancestors that took place during her reign and or during the entire period of the British trafficking of Africans, enslavement, indentureship, and colonization."
Why is it that in Jamaica, people who wear their hair naturally are discriminated against in school? Why is it that in Jamaica, a predominantly black nation, that, you know, poor people who are black don't have land when their ancestors have built the British Empire?
Back in Australia, the Republican movement has also been stirring.
Hi, Craig. Thanks for meeting me at this rather symbolic statue of Queen Victoria.
Yeah, it really
And Craig
is.
Foster is at the coalface.
So what is it about this royal family that makes you feel countries like Jamaica and Australia should go their own way?
Well, what's changed, I think, in probably the last 20 years, but and accelerated in the last few, is the journey that Australia's now taking with First Nations and listening and coming to new understandings on our history. If we look at, you know, our silence and our denial around the reality of dispossession and theft of the country, you know, what that's done is that's essentially kept us chained to that moment in 1788, all of us.
Craig talks about reconciliation and emancipation, but I want to know why he thinks becoming a republic can help that process.
So statues like this of Captain Cook have been a bit of a focal point of anger on days like Australia Day. Mm-hmm. How do you feel becoming a republic would help address some of that anger?
We need full independence to grow into our contemporary skin. Genuine multiculturalism, in my view, means absolute equality and access for every cultural background, ethnicity and race in Australia. While ever we have a monarchy as the head of state of this country, then that's not real.